Thank you, Sheikha, for the introduction. Hello, everyone, and thank you so much for investing your time to be here with us today. My name is Ahmed Abusamra. I am the Outreach Coordinator at Emirates Nature WWF, and I will be moderating this session. During the lockdown, we at Emirates Nature and our partners had the amazing opportunity to speak to our youth, UAE's youth, through our platform, Connect with Nature, where we had a series of 9 tailored youth circles that included key decision makers and experts who had a dialogue with youth on various environmental issues. The findings of these sessions have been released in a white paper recently, and they sound very alarming. And so our topic for today is youth want a greener recovery to shape UAE's next 50 years, where the goal is to highlight the perspective of youth on green recovery and also see their role in the next 50 years. And so without further ado, let me introduce to you our panelists for today. We have Alaa Masood, who is passionate about nature and is one of the UAE's ambassadors for nature. He's pursuing a career in human resources and he aims to live a healthy, sustainable life. We have Pavan Jaini. He's a junior studying at New York University, Abu Dhabi, majoring in social research. And he has an experience working in nature and the environment in India and UAE. And we have Nadine Kassab. Nadine is a passionate interior designer, and she is also one of the ambassadors for nature in UAE. And her main goal is to contribute to a healthier living spaces and to integrate sustainability into the design process. Welcome, Alaa, welcome, Pavan, and welcome, Nadine, to the session. And so before we dive into the findings of this white paper, you know, it seems that all of you, you know, coming from different fields, you all took on a journey to be more environmentally friendly, to be more sustainable. And so I'll start with you, Alaa. You know, we have seen you, you're part of our community for more than a year now, and you've gone through big changes, and now you are one of the UAE ambassadors for nature. Tell us a little bit about your journey.
Thank you, Ahmed, for introducing us. Actually, I'm very blessed to be like part of this community. So as I grow up in love with nature, I always had the passion to spend most of my time outdoors. And that's how my journey started with Connect with Nature community. One of my friends was introduced me to one of the workout activity, and it turns out to have like 4 days in a row to discover different natural sites in UAE by Connect with Nature. So after that, I was like involved in most of the Connect with Nature events, like beach cleanup, informative hikes, sustainable workshops, and environmental talks as well. So since September 2019, I take a pledge to discover this country more. And until now, I have been like to many natural attractions, like hidden oases, a trip to different mountains and valleys through hikes, and some archaeological sites, abandoned village in the middle of the mountains. And like after that, I was like very embarrassed about like the beauty of this place. So now talking about the ambassadorship program, after being selected as a natural ambassador, me and my other fellow ambassador, we have gone through like different stages. And like the first one, it was like the learning one. So we were like gaining a knowledge of like climate change, the biodiversity and the importance to our ecosystem. It plus like food security and how it's important to our daily lifestyle. The second stage, which is action one. So what we have learned, we have to reflect it, right? And that's how I start to compose like in my home our like waste and use it for our planet. Also trying to reduce the carbon emissions as to take like carpooling methods for our trips and many other changes in my lifestyle. The third one, which is inspiring stage, to inspire and encourage other youth to be like more eco-friendly and more sustainable. So throughout like the last year, and especially during the pandemic, it made me like realize that's like the important how we have to preserve our nature.
Thank you so much for your insight. It's quite a journey that you have gone through, and I find it really interesting as well that you started composting at your home. Hopefully that will be inspiration for a lot of youth. But indeed, as you said, you know, during the pandemic, I think we all had this realization that nature is really important. And I'll move on to you, Pavan. You know, it seems in the white paper that, you know, you have told us that this pandemic was quite alarming and actually was like a wake-up call. So tell us a little bit more about this wake-up call. What is it exactly?
Right, Ahmed. So I would say that this wake-up call has come in the form of this pandemic. And this pandemic has really shown us that the relationship that we share with nature is integral in both the creation and prevention of some pandemics. And this relationship that we currently share with nature is very exploitative. It is very one way in which all we're doing is taking from the nature and not really giving anything back. We're not protecting nature. We're not protecting our environments. And we're facing real world repercussions because of that. And I came to this realization through this pandemic, where the way we are treating our nature, the way we're treating our environment, is now having tangible repercussions, tangible results through the form of this pandemic. COVID-19, as everyone is well aware of, happened because instead of conserving and protecting wildlife species, we were trading and consuming them. And that has led us to our current predicament. And it sort of put us in a very interesting position where nobody wants another pandemic, but in order to prevent a pandemic, we need to do many different things. Our attitudes towards nature must change. I definitely don't want another pandemic. I'm sure none of you guys want another one as well. And in fact, I don't feel I'm well prepared for one. And 42% of youth like me in the UAE agree with me that we are just completely ill-prepared to face another pandemic. And so now the question that must be asked is, how do we prevent such pandemics from happening in the future? And I strongly believe, and I think throughout our discussions with the youth in those nine reimagined series that we've had, has been that nature needs to be a key and central role of all our decision making. And 97% of the UAE's youth believe, and I also strongly, strongly believe this, that wildlife conservation and species conservation has to play an integral role. It has to be a priority when it comes to the prevention of future pandemics. And so, as you can see, things need to change. Like, definitely our mindset towards nature needs to change. Like I had mentioned before, we have a very, currently the state of this relationship that we share with nature is very one-sided. All we're doing is taking, we're not really giving anything back. You know, forests are in shambles, global temperatures are rising. Everything is just going to hell, basically. And this pandemic has really been a wake-up call that it's time to start moving. It's time to start taking more action. And like I said, I don't want another pandemic. None of you guys want one as well. So I'd just like to reiterate in conclusion that things definitely, definitely need to change.
I definitely agree with you, Pavan. That was a great insight. I think, you know, once we start having nature in the heart of our decision, I think that can be also a key element in how we move forward. And I agree with you that definitely there is a mass change that needs to happen, especially in the mindset. So I'll jump back to you, Alaa. So the youth have highlighted many pressing issues, you know, from plastic, from waste, and, you know, throughout the pandemic as well. And they highlighted that change needs to happen. So what do you think? How do you think we can come about this change, or how can we create it?
So there is actually like plenty ways. So I think we need to set up like a green recovery actions by circular economy and reinvent our system of production and consumption. Like try to eliminate as much as like the waste and to have like more effective of like the waste management. So this will have like the potential to boost our economy as well. And there is like some point government can like prioritize for a greener recovery. And one of them like to accelerate a low carbon transitions and also like strengthen in like biodiversity protection by investing in conservation, plus like enhancing environmental health through better air quality, water and sanitation. So there is one of like a youth statistics that says like 73 of youth think reducing single use plastic should be priority, and also to reduce the overconsumption of our resources. So like this all result will become by collective and individual of efforts.
Yeah, definitely. A lot needs to be changed, but including everything in a circular economic, in a circular economy or a circular economic way, I think that's the way to move forward and can be the key to a green recovery. And I would like to move to you, Nadine. I know you've been doing a lot of work around nature and the environment. And I would like to ask you basically, where do you see the role of youth, or what your advice would be to young, passionate people like yourself who want to see a green recovery?
Thank you so much, Ahmed, for that. As you might know, and as the audience might know, over the next few years, the world will have the largest youth population ever. This is why I believe the governments and leaders need to start thinking how to embrace this huge youth population and mobilize their talent to the benefit of the society. Likewise, we the youth are very eager to become involved and to voice our opinions and our ideas. I'll have you know that 94% of the youth want to prioritize healing their relationship with nature. But in order for us, the youth, to actually cause action, we need to be mentored and guided by the specialists. This can be initiated by example, by allowing the youth to be engaged in the current environmental talks and in the environmental recovery programs. Also, more focused groups can be created where youth feel confident to voice their opinions and ideas. As for my advice for the youth, I would really recommend them to not wait to be taught everything. Instead, they need to go to the ground and experience things for themselves. They need to get as much training as they can, either online training or on-ground training. And they also need to start exploring new fields of study, because in the future, the green recovery is going to force the economy to restructure and to open up more green jobs. And this is when the youth action will come in place, because they will fill these roles and then they will be equipped with the right skills and the right set of skills to actually cause change. Moreover, I would really encourage them just in general to learn more about the environmental issues and familiarize themselves with the solutions that are currently available, so they are well equipped. And lastly, I would just tell them to be loud and to voice their concerns, voice their ideas, and not be shy, because our lives are at stake here, and we really need to start taking action.
Thank you so much, Nadine, for sharing your advice. I would definitely agree with that. Youth should always not wait to be guided, but like if you see no guidance, you should take action and try to get as much training and as much information as possible. I definitely agree with that. To end the session, I have one last question for all of you. How do you all see UAE in the next 50 years? How do you see a sustainable green UAE, shaped by a green recovery? We'll start with you, Alaa.
Okay. So I would like to see increasing in the percentage of a green area in UAE by growing more plants. Also, I imagine more of sustainable infrastructure to build cycling tracks. So our next generation will have they can go to school by cycling. Also to have electric public transportation. Also to have more mangrove trees, as it plays a big role to reducing carbon emissions.
Over to you, Nadine.
As for me, I imagine driving down the road, seeing a lot of greenery. I imagine having clean oceans, fresh air to breathe. I also imagine all the electricity that we require will be powered by renewable energy or through solar panels. I can also imagine that single-use plastic is history now, and we don't know about that anymore.
That would definitely be amazing. No more single-use. Over to you, Pavan.
I share very similar dreams to both my panelists over here, where walkability and city planning come into better effect. There's more sustainable ways of doing both of those things, public transport as well, and definitely having more indigenous plants and mangroves and gaff trees being more visible, and just having more tree cover in general. I also think that food security, growing food locally, and sustainable ways of having food produced in the UAE is something that I would look forward to in the next 50 years. I imagine me and my friends growing some vegetables in our own little gardens, and just a general reduction of food waste as well, I think would be a great thing to see in the future.
Thank you so much for sharing your insights. I think that's really interesting, you know, from having everything powered by solar, we have sustainable infrastructure, and also we consume more locally. I think that's all about the right things that we all want to say or see as well. So thank you for tuning in for this session today. UAE youth have told us loud and clear that nature, the environment matters to them. And we know that the next few years are critical to put the planet on the path to a better future. And so we need to have everyone, we need to have the government, businesses, financial institutions, and the people as well come together to see UAE, a more greener, more sustainable UAE. Thank you everyone for tuning in.
Thank you, Ahmed.